Yeah, I am Israel Paul, and welcome to my TV, Financial Paul TV. It's actually on YouTube. So you want to go there and search for more information on finance that we are sharing. So today, I want to talk about how you cannot be broke. You know, before I go, I am a businessman, an investor. I started my e-commerce business 6 years ago, an investment 6 years ago, and I gained quite a number of experiences through those businesses that I have done through importation and e-commerce business and several other digital businesses. Also, with my professional education from Institute of Chartered Accountants, I set out Become Rich Africa, an organization aimed at providing financial information. So on Facebook, we have Become Rich Africa. On YouTube, it's just my personal Financial Talk TV. So we want to talk about how you can never be broke. What are the things that you need to understand that will make you not to be broke, especially during this pandemic, during this period, during this crisis? Financial crisis, and there are two things you need to understand. Number one, you need to seek for how to increase your income. That is very, very paramount. And number two, how to reduce your expenses. And I wrote down some things right on my book on how you can increase your income and how to reduce your expenses. You need to understand that in this period, one of the things you need to focus on your expenses on are your necessities, so that you will move one of the ways you need to know that you are doing well, if when there's an emergency, can you bring out some amount of hundreds of thousands of millions to recoup to solve that? If you can do that, then you might need to look forward to how you can reduce your expenses. One of the ways you can reduce your expenses is to budget. Look at an overview of what you spend on a daily basis. We are still going to the income source in a few minutes, so I just want to talk about the expenses. Now look at, what can I do? What do I spend on a daily basis? How can I budget to know what I'm spending on my food, clothing, and shelter? Concerning the food, you might want to buy food in bulk. That's one of the ways to ease the expenses, especially for food. Buy them in bulk, put them at home, and start cooking them. Then for the clothing, of course, there is no much party in this currency to a position that we are in. So you want to avoid buying much clothes, or you just use what you have. Then shelter, very paramount. Those are the ways to curb your expenses. One of the things you can also do is to avoid overspending. There's some things you don't need, don't buy them. That way you better position yourself not to be broke. Then looking into how to make more money. You have a current source of income now. That is sure. But the matter is, it's not bringing in sufficient fund that you need, or it's not bringing what you really want it to bring. You understand? So the truth of the matter is that you have to seek for another source of income. In this current position that we are in this country, in this current, even the rich don't have one source of income. They have several companies. Some have real estate. I've mentioned in this. Some have investments. Some have businesses. You need to look forward. Look within you. What are other sources of income that I can create? We know that there is one single source, and that has been bringing you income. Now, what can I create? I would liken this to a story about the widow in the Bible. She's the wife of a prophet, and the prophet died. Now the prophet has been owing some people, some creditors, and they are coming to her to threaten her because of the debt her husband is owing. Then she ran to Elijah and told Elijah, some creditors are about to take my children because of the debt my husband is owing. Then Elijah asks her, what do you have in your house? A lot of people are looking at it that, oh, I don't know, what can I do to make money? What you have to make money is in you. You just have to make use of your eyes, your mind, the eyes of your mind. You can sit down in a place and think about, what is it that I know? What am I doing? What am I good at? What do I have experience on? What you have experience on, what you are good at, what you have been doing, what you are passionate about, can give you other sources of income. You can look at it in this light. If you have been, we have been talking about, we have been just like I do, talking about business and information and investment. I can make money from that. You know, if you are into a particular niche, take for instance, you love healthy living, you can monetize it now by looking. If you look within you, that oh, I have experience in healthy living foods food that you can eat that can make you healthy in this period, you can start a YouTube channel. You can start a blog, and you might be wondering, how can I? You need to be effective now because of this. I don't want this video to be long, but I will say what I want to say. You have to be effective now to create more source of income. A lot of people are trading business for effectiveness. How effective are you? Do you want to create a website that is going to teach people on health and beauty? Why have you not done it? Do you want to create a YouTube channel and reach out to a lot of people? You can make money from YouTube channel. In fact, there are 5 ways you can make money from YouTube channel apart from AdSense. And I mentioned it in my video. You can check my channel. Click the subscribe button to be getting more information. So you need to look within you. What are my experiences? What do I like? What do I know? What do I do? Am I selling? If you have just all your life you've been selling at Computer Village, there are experiences from Computer Village that you can use to make money. Take for instance, you can be talking about new phones, new gadgets. You have access to gadgets in the Computer Village. Do a 5-minute video, post it online. People are trying to watch gadget descriptions online. They want to just know about the latest iPhone. Not to just know about the latest iPhone 11X Pro Max. I don't use iPhone. I use a Samsung phone, so I don't really follow the trend. A lot of people follow the trend. When new phone comes out, iPhone, they want to get it. I don't follow that because I think about how to build an investment. One of the things, iPhone also is an investment because if you use it for 1 year, you can sell it all at a very, very reasonable amount. So moving away from that, you can do what, look within you. There is something you can use to make money. And how do you look within? You can just stay in a solitary place, in a place, and just begin to think with your mind and begin to reason, what are the experiences that I have? What are the things that I know? What are the businesses that I have involved in? What are my experiences? Couple them together and create something. Be effective now. My YouTube channel, do I want to post my YouTube channel? What is that business that I want to kickstart? Maybe I want to kickstart a supermarket business. What are you doing as regards that? Maybe I want to kickstart a POS business. Kickstart something. Be effective, because if you are not effective, it will affect other people. Now, this is how it affects. Take for instance, I'm not effective and I can't make money to buy what I need. But if I'm effective, I have made money. I want to buy food in bulk. I go to the foodstuff seller. I buy those food in bulk. The money the foodstuff seller makes, he uses it to restock his item. And from restocking the item, he pays somebody else and buys other things. So the money is moving. If you are not effective, it affects the whole economy. So you have to be effective to make more money. Thank you so much. If I keep on talking, time will be going. So you want to go to my YouTube channel, Financial Paul. If you are watching this on my YouTube, just click the subscribe button, as we have a lot of practical information to share with us on how to make, manage, and multiply money. This is just a more of a motivation. Thank you so much. Remain intelligent. Bye bye.